Hi, Saviors, GH here. Here we are again with another looking at the possible future video. Let's just take a look at it. Let's do this. And here it is, guys. Number one, Relic System. And as we see here, guys, there's a new gear slot beside the sub slot. And based on the next image here, looks like we're gonna go Super Saiyan with the new Relic System. The shield and the weapon changed appearance, that's cool, but I'm slightly nervous about this because it might cost us a minimum of 1 billion. I hope it's not Arc Stones because, oh my god, Arc Stones are gonna be 1 billion each, and that's if you're lucky. Anywho, I hope I'm wrong. Let's dive a bit more deeper. And here is the Relic UI or menu, whatever you want to call it. There's the Relic item and there's this Recharge Relic Power. How much for each point of Relic Power? 1 TP? That's gonna be so funny if they did that. Anyway, according to this, Relic Power is a permanent resource that does not recover automatically and you must use items obtained as rewards from content to replenish it. The Relic Liberation skill is designed to be very powerful and difficult to use, so you can use it in a losing situation to turn the tide of battle. So, if I understand this correctly, Relic Power are obtained through content, which is how it's supposed to be. I hope that's how it is. Anyway, next here is acquiring and leveling up Relic equipment. Oh, okay. Here it is, guys. Relics can be obtained through quests when your character is level 450 or higher and is a growth type item that will accompany the Savior's journey from there onward. So, it's just a quest like the Arc Stones. Oh my, I just said like the Arc Stones. Oh no, they might add another super rare item that only whales and botters can get. Oh no, if that is the case, then this is another content for the whales. Nothing changes. Anyway, here's a description of a relic item. Damn, it looks like an Arc Stone description. It makes me nervous. Relics provide an increase to all main stats and further increase based on the relic's level. And based upon what I can see here, we can equip different gems to the relic. Here's a cyan gem, magenta gem, and a black gem. I couldn't get much out of the description, so just look at it. Here's some Korean stuff I can't understand. And okay, here's the proper description of the gems. Now, according to this, the cyan gem consumes 200 magic power when using the Super Saiyan mode. And what it does is stun, then debuffs the enemy, then damages the enemy every 1 second, and your damage to the debuff enemy is increased. Okay, doesn't seem much to warrant the Super Saiyan name. Okay, I guess let's just call it the pay-to-win mode. Anyway, here's the magenta gem. As I see it, it's a final damage increase gem. Okay, let's hope this content can be used by a regular player. Let's pray. Okay, what's next here is relic content and rewards. Okay, here's the content that is described a while ago wherein we get relic powers or items. I can't understand the image, but as I read here, it says can be run 2 times per week. Wow. I'm assuming there's a voucher sold in the cash shop. Solo hunt voucher, anyone? Next here is Relic Quest. Relic quests are composed of repeatable quests that can be checked through a new separate tab in the quest window, F5. Relic quests are created in a way that allows you to easily complete their objectives by doing content that you will already be doing as a savior, and are composed of main quests and subquests, so you can get rewards from each one by clearing them. Okay, this is nice. Seems like everyone will partake in this relic quest, but of course, it's not here yet, and IMC might put something here that will disappoint us. They always do. Calm your tits for a minute, guys. Anyway, let's read on to the next planned update. And it's number 2, Equipment Item Upgrade Increase. Oh, I know this already. It's the Bybora level 4. It is what it is, guys. Let's proceed to the next one, which is the Goddess Demon Armor level expansion. It's the same thing. The maximum level of the demon and goddess armor has been increased to 3. This will make the Arc Stones even more expensive than it is right now, because whales are gonna buy Arc Stones for 1.5 billion when the update comes. And the rest of you, just watch the Arc Stone in IMC video that I got. The link is in the description. You're gonna have fun watching that. IMC really needs to make Arc Stones more available. Maybe put 3 untradeable Arc Stone fragments in the Mercenary Badge shop so it can't be RMT'd and everybody can partake on the content that IMC is making. Yeah. Okay, here's a new arc and it's for healers. Okay. Then common team attributes. Wait, what? It looks like there will be attributes that will increase stats. Okay. And then number 3, reputation system and content added. Are they imitating Genshin Impact here? Like Klaipeda reputation, then Orsha reputation, then Fendimian reputation? What's the reward? A glider? Okay, anyway, there's nothing much notable to read here. They're just saying we got a reputation system here like Genshin Impact. Yeah. Next here is the goddess follower and goddess card. When you reach a certain point in the new episode, you can expand your card menu to include the goddess follower menu. This tab is a place where you can equip a goddess card that is purchased through the reputation store. Okay. Seems like the reward on the reputation store is cards. And it takes a lot of effort to acquire the card item. Oh no. But it has a similarly powerful effect. Okay. What kind of effort? Money effort? Or gameplay effort? I hope it's gameplay effort. Please. Please make it gameplay effort. Okay, number 4 here is the revamp of existing content. Most notable here is they are increasing the level cap in episode 13 update. And of course, that goes along with new areas that according to this, it drops level 3 by Boro weapons or even level 2 goddess or demon armors. With a very low chance. Oh, okay, there's the clarification. A very low chance. Like, you're better off winning the Mega Lotto. What else do we have here? Automatic matching has been added to Challenge Mode and Division Singularity Modes. Oh, okay, I'm interested in this. Because this can theoretically make new players, the fresh blood of the game, participate more often on CM and Singularity. This is probably the best news that we have today. Because, guys, we must make the newer players feel welcome so they will stay and the population will get healthier because of that. And we might see a Tree of Savior someday with 10,000 players again. And that will be glorious. I hope IMC can make this work because we need this right now. Okay, what else do we have here? According to this, wait. Let's focus on what matters. The challenge mode level 400 to 450. 450 plus and division singularity level 450 plus. The requirement for the 400 to 450 is weapons should be level 400 plus, legend, fixed I-core equip, transcendence 5 plus. This is very easy even for a new player. And I'm assuming IMC is gonna give away either a Varna set or a Disney set soon because new players need it. Armor here is level 400 plus, legend, fixed I-core equip, transcendence 5 plus. That I-core, I think the Galimive I-core would suffice. Accessories, level 300 plus, unique, new basic accessories available. Oh, okay. Just a unique accessories. Looks like the auto-matching is gonna be doable since the requirement is doable. Then, Arc Stone equip, Arc Dummy not allowed, okay? If the quest arc is allowed, then it's all good. Then seal equip. Okay. Then the level 450 plus is mostly the same with higher level equipment, 440 gears, and a level 3 arc. For the auto matching in division singularity level 450 plus, it's trans 8, level 440 gears, a level 5 arc, oh no, and a legend set effect. Okay, that requirement is a bit steep for newer players, definitely, and it might affect the queuing time. So that's a bit of a worry. What they could do is just make a Singularity Easy Mode auto-matching with less requirements. Because I can tell you right now, that auto-matching requirement for Singularity level 450+, is not gonna work, 500%. And most people are just gonna queue forever and waste time. IMC have done this before and looks like they haven't learned anything. This whole thing here should be reworked because GH doesn't approve of this. This is a waste of time. It's a bit steep for the majority of players. And according to this, there is only one level of auto-matching and we can use buffs to compensate the lack of class, like healer I suppose. And this paragraph here basically states, if you have a low DPS, you get low silver. I think they're doing this to prevent AFK and leeching. I just hope the max damage required is not a whale damage. According to this next paragraph, it's business as usual in the normal fields challenge mode. You can proceed with any players and party as usual. And there will only be 5 stages compared to the previous 7 stages. Oh my god, this is good news! And the time limit for each stage has been reduced. This is a good change because right now, CMs are a bit of a time wastey. Making it much more faster but still the same difficulty and the rewards are the same, it's gonna be welcome. And there's some silver penalty here depending on the level difference, okay? Makes sense. And here's the important part, guys. In general, both challenge mode types will have monsters with buff gimmicks that harms players that are not actively playing. I guess this is IMC's fix to multi-client silver farmers. We'll see what happens there when it comes. Next here is dimensional collapse point area transfer. Yeah, they're transferring the DCP NPC. And then what we have here is add field drop items. When you defeat monsters with a level difference of 20 or less in the field, you now have a low chance to obtain challenge mode vouchers. What? In the field? And various legend raid vouchers. And it's non-transferable. Which means, you gotta use your main account for botting the vouchers. Which will be risky for our botter friends. What's up, dude? How's Bobas nowadays? Peace, bruh. World peace. World peace, everyone. Heal the world. Make it a better place. Anyway, they could still use a slightly geared alternate account, but still, it's gonna take some work that can easily be taken away by a ban. But as we all know, IMC only bans people when you make a fuss about it. If you're a botter, as long as you keep it on the down low, IMC won't ban your bot. This is interesting. In the end, it all comes down to IMC manually banning bots, which they should have been doing from the start. Removing the silver from the fields helped, for sure. I've been patrolling the bot areas and there is less bots. There are still bots, but they're getting scraps of badges. So that's fine, but still, IMC should ban. In the end, IMC will still need to put resources on manually banning botters in the game. Ah, what a mess. Then what we have next is tutorial slash guide improvements. Okay, I can guarantee you, this will be a waste of time. At least they're trying. And then I think this is the last one. It's the last one we're gonna look at because the video is getting too long. And it's the Legend Guilting Raid and Guild Quest added. I can guarantee you, this Guilting Raid is not doable 1000% by the majority of players. You will see some Kraken and RMT sellers doing this, then selling the items obtained there in Discord. IMC, just make the items obtainable there untradeable for the meantime until you guys find a way to fix the whale raid of yours. Don't be hyped for this Legend Guilting because this is not an update for us. Okay, what else? The new guild boss raid. I think it's Guilting. It's gonna be like the Boruta one. I hope they distribute the rewards there properly because the raid is meh. Anyway, that's it. Let's just read this final sentence here. And what it says is, we have finished posting the series of episode 13 update information, which will be released in December. That means we get this update maybe March if we're lucky, or February. And that's it, guys. What do you think? Is this another whale exclusive content? Or is it finally the content that's gonna make the server full of people? Share your thoughts in the comment section down below. And if you like the video, hit the thumbs up, share, and then subscribe to be part of the Gaming Hardcore family. And as always, this is Gaming Hardcore. See you in the next one.